Hello. All right. Hello. Okay. I'm thinking we just throw an orb in there for the eye. Four. Hello, sewage monster. Welcome to I don't know how to make an eyeball whatsoever. Seems good enough. Hello, Krito. Why do I have a story for you? What does that mean? I'm concerned. How many disciples? Okay. That works. Let me move this microphone. I believe I have joined a scavenger tribe. Good. Six of them follow me for like 12 seconds. How long did you stay in garbage waste? Couldn't find my way out. It's not, you just have to keep going in a direction and pass one of the tolls. But yeah. Are you out of there now? you still have all the scavengers following you? I mean, it's good that you made friends with them instead of murdering all of them. You find pearls with pass call. Oh, okay. There is some location. There is a location that I'll respawn in, but I gotta know where it is. There's a lot of pearls in that zone once you start looking for it, but I don't know. A lot of things can happen, really. Oh, it's not. Oh, wait. We can. Now struggling there. Makes sense. Where can I rename this? I just click on it harder. I mean, I figured it out. Alright, I've conceived of the dumbest way possible to mirror this. I feel like it's not working. It appears to not be working. There's no way it's Z, right? I should just be able to copy a bit. Hello! Hello to you, Z. Hello, QOSC as well. Around the head object. I just say, you know. Get rid of my dumb methods. Where is it? Is there a mirror about? Because we correctly want the eye. Okay. Not what I thought that would mean. But it worked. Thank you. Just leave it at circles for now. But that's it for that. Rename this. Now we get to pretend we know what we're doing with this. Why is it? Excuse me. Okay. This one. Can I force it to have a texture? I'm forgetting. Let's see. Oh, wait. Go back real quick. Apply. 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 Save as, we'll have a same version, but with it applied. you Lizord. Before you start doing all that. That's what I'm doing. That's what I just did. Bring us the circling bone. New material principle. It'll make a blank image texture for me, right? I can't choose a color, no! Rendered, not solid view. I'm gonna change it to this in a second. Not the full render, the base color. Color grid. I know there's reasons to have them have those grids, but let's see if I can do something with it. Code finder. I believe I can actually. Can I open where it is? I'll make this smaller a bit so I can see. I just want to make sure I get the right color for that brain. Use my image. This. Excuse me. It's beautiful. Absolutely beautiful.
As of May 20th, 2014, Wi-Fi connection service for this software has been discontinued. Please visit our website for a list of current Wi-Fi.
He's beautiful. Oh, okay. What's actually? Oh, I do have a light source. Beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. Alright. I don't think we actually need to. Maybe we need to. The one thing I'm just starting to think about now is maybe I model the teeth. Maybe we just texture them. That is the one thing I didn't do. Ooh, pa 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 boo doo do 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 pa 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 pa. However, we have other problems now. I know there's a way to rotate, and I'm just not remembering what it is. Like control E, mark seam, beautiful. Mark some seams real quick. Didn't do anything at all. I don't know why. Do 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 do. Oh, that's bad. Oh no. Well, maybe I should have kept it mirrored. Is there a shortcut for it? It doesn't look like it. Yes, command. That would be useful right now. Oh, wait, I need to message someone. F3. Brilliant diamond. What's the Colossan clear seam? I don't think this is faster. Because it puts it directly on my marker when I do control E. Ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba. I feel like I should put a line through the middle here, but I don't know. Matter anymore. I just press R. I pressed Control R again. That's not right. I must edge bevel weight. Oh, weight power, edge crease. When in what situation do you want to use a crease over a seam? I actually don't know exactly what the difference is. Ah, no.
We match all of the cash back you earn at the end of your first year.
Please stop. It's that. Oh no. Okay, there we go. Hello, pink fluffy kittens. Our weight's like an influence subdivision. During unfolding, I believe, right? I'm not wrong. We're gonna start from the beginning of this magical song. Hello. I'm doing things I probably don't need to, but I want to anyway. That being helping with unfolding. Really? I really thought both were unfolding. I see you've already found the points rewards. Hello. That should unfold correctly, right? Yes, if you want to ask any questions of what I'm doing, think, feel free to do so, even though I don't know everything. What am I gonna do? I didn't think you would check immediately what points could do. Do I want to link that? I've had a lot of people not notice that's a thing. All three of them. I might have gotten rid of the food one, because it doesn't really work. Also because I don't have hands, but I am a gremlin. I'm gonna add the hand thing. Give me a second. Also, if you may notice, you never be able to not see it. One of the bits of fluff in the back. For some reason, there's a black triangle connected to it. I don't know why it's there. It doesn't show up anywhere except when I actually put it in the VC face. And I don't know why. Because it exports just fine. Then you can look at what you've exported in Unity, and it's not there. And then you put it in the VC face in Tifa, and it's there, and I'm very confused. It's never been there in any previous exports I've done either. Thanks, I hate it. Good. Can you see it from here? No, you can't. Nope. You kind of saw it there for a second. There it is again. Okay. Let's not worry about it. If that was a box, it probably fell off immediately. Curse. Anyways, Lizard. Yes. So right now, I'm setting creases so that I can unwrap it. Probably shouldn't have saved it then. We'll save it with all the creases. Do we even unwrap? We can do a circle around it, I suppose. So everywhere I put one of these things, that's how it's going to cut it when I unwrap it. It'll make sense in a second. Which is important for texturing when you want to mess with it yourselves. The only reason why I'm really doing it is because I want to get used to it. And I want to make a purple arm specific. Since they're default unwrapped. Are they really? Okay. We'll check that out then. See if that works. So yeah, the one thing I'm not sure is if I should model the teeth, which would probably be its own model, because this doesn't, it's not really gonna work. Maybe I could do something. Either that, or I make it entirely textured, which might be the way to do it here. Actually, no, wait. Yeah, maybe we don't do that. Given that it's technically its own thing there. Unwrap this thing. First. The Lizord move. We're gonna be trying to rig it, yes. Thank you. we want to just cut it down the middle, I don't think that really matters. It kind of matters. I gotta do that the other way. Powerful Lizar. Maybe shouldn't have undid the mirror. We're almost there. Also, always have quads. Don't ever use a triangle. I'm only using a triangle here because I don't care for right here. That is what, there's one thing you definitely want to know going forward is that you want to use quads. 4 vertices per face. That's it. Why tries bad? Because tries, when you animate something, it's a lot easier to make it move if it's quads instead of tries, because tries are a lot more stiff, at least from what I'm aware of. to use them exclusively for... So, one thing you should know... is that, despite those old models... using... despite those old models being a bunch of tries, it's still technically a quad that's split up into two triangles. Because that's essentially what happens. Except it can bend either way when it's a quad to begin with. That doesn't really work, but... yes, but it's funny. No. No. I send you all of Slug 64 model? No. I'm guessing you sent me it just now. Maybe I did see that. It seems wildly familiar. You just basically took some squares and made them round. Which works for it. You need the texture there. I almost feel like if you made the face more square for this model, it might look a bit more interesting. Yeah, but unwrapping. We're doing unwrapping right now. This is. There should be ways to default. And you're using a bunch of default shapes, so maybe it would work out well. This looks like it would kill me. So unwrapping is about being as efficient as possible. If you're okay with making sure everything's perfect, unwrapping is easy because you don't need to fuss about it for terribly long for it to be perfect. Because it just needs to work, and then it's good enough. Paint on the 3 model. Yeah. Not like we have some fancy thing. I should be able to... I don't actually remember how to do it. You beautiful. Where unwrap? Where unwrap? Oh, you to unwrap. Oh, what is that? What is that? What is that? Oh, doesn't really matter. Actually, what is that though? What is this right there? Oh, I didn't select everything. There we are. Okay, now it makes sense. Need to select all. I just do that. That works though. We got some problems there, so you just want to make things not overlap, but it probably doesn't matter for what we're doing. Some of these are pretty good, like that's pretty good. Like, what is this? Which one is this? Yeah, that makes sense. I think they just need to be split from each other. But, yeah, I like that. This is the tail, both of these. Seemingly. It looks different from each other. You are the problem. This other side already had it, but this side didn't. I never did any of this in my original class, which at the time it really didn't matter. Just kind of made things solid colors anyway. You to unwrap. I need to remember that. Alright, well, what's going on here? Everything else is pretty good though. Can't believe you at least had a class. Class was not good. You do not take 3D modeling classes at my college. Guy knew what he was talking about, and he was also like, if you guys are actually interested, don't go here anymore. I considered some online classes, but I don't think it's worth it anymore. Yeah, right now, YouTube has enough, and there's a lot of paid stuff as well. Like, that's not like internships or whatever. There's a lot of paid stuff, as in like $10 to $60 for hundreds of hours of stuff from a professional. You need to like know who's good and who's not, but it's still a lot. I also question what this is. Yeah, YouTube videos have enough to these days. Let's split this off. That'll do it enough. I feel like there's a bit too many cuts, but does it really matter? Also, you have friendly moves. Yes. Everyone used to hate the interface. I thought it was funny. Because I thought it was great. Oh, that is different. Best thing about Blender is it has everything in one place, because generally a lot of other places there's one program for modeling, one program for sculpting, one program for this and that and that, and so there's, it's still like that, and like those specialized things are much better in their specific jobs. But Blender having everything in one place, and if you're just doing whatever you want, good enough. So it's A to select everything? Alright. Oh, that's a problem. Is Blender's 2D animation like even passable? I have no idea. I just know it exists. There's a lot of Python scripting as well. You probably have to look up what other people do. How do I change color? Alright. We've got some trash geometry, but where are the kids on YouTube? I've never heard of that one. Hello, pseudo. Worthy. Oh, they're 2D animation. Austin Powers 4! Must find the white square. There it is. Is that just shininess? That one just has a small puff. Oh, it is split off from everything, isn't it? That's a little bit more reasonable. Although there is a lot of small bits just around. I feel like that's not good, but I'm not gonna worry about it. I think you can see like a heat map if you really wanted to, of like if it's stretched or not. If I wanted to make it really, really good, but we're not about it. DM'd me on Twitch. What in the world we're coming to? It looks so derpy. Good! You see this? What about this isn't derpy? But also they should have teeth. You are correct. Look at that unwrapping. Beautiful. Is that connected? What's going on there? Everything else looks fine though. So why is it black? I know why it's black. The pink's a little annoying to look at. It's very bright. Kind of cut that up in a weird way. Oh no. Oh wait, we're fine. Why is one okay and the other not? I also do not have the skills to do the fur. I mean, I just get the general shape and then don't worry about the actual fur. Because you'll make the fur a separate object that you add on top of it. Like a cone. Except you make like a curved cone. If you really want to have fur, otherwise just have it be a flat color. It's still the same bits? Yep. I didn't split that off. Oh, I went all the way down there. And this is just done poorly. Not even sure what I want to do. They look like each other now. Hello, Mooshpa. Hello. Why did it only fix it for one? Oh. I'm doing... okay. Just trying to UV unwrap this right now. Maybe we split this off. Well, so yeah, if anything doesn't make sense, please ask. Why? there even a seam there? I can't tell. What? Merge and merge by distance. Yeah. Press M for merge and merge by. So that'll make them join into each other if there's ones that I've accidentally extruded on top of each other. Which could have happened. It looks like that did happen. Okay. I didn't think that happened. No, it definitely did. I think I did extrude there. That's exactly what happened. It said remove deserve hurries. Then why did everything change? It certainly did, because I couldn't see that there. I probably accidentally extruded like 5 times anyway. Also, one thing for at least pink to know. So say we're here. They were making a thing. In edit mode. You have vertices, right? And then you have up here. Now you have lines. Now you have up here, and now you have faces. And you can do all sorts of whatever you want with these, if you want. And it's amazing. You also can press 1, 2, and 3 to do this as well. And then the way I make moving these around is G. A very important thing to know is pressing G twice can make you move vertices along lines. And yeah. Then I showed you Control R, which makes the line very important. Okay, hello, Cyberbones. I think we're gonna do this by distance, move 0 vertices, but I believe nothing. Making hind legs hard, yes. Just gotta spend some time. So the one thing that I'm questioning that you're doing is, how are you actually making it? Are you just like... Let me get it. Are you just like, have cube... edit mode... subdivide... move dots individually? Is that what you're doing? Is the thing that I do have to ask? No, okay. Please don't be doing that. Using the subdivision modif- Well, you can subdivide by pressing right click and it's right there. But also what I'm saying is don't do stuff like that. Like, don't move things into place. Like, if you move this into place, then you have this giant stretch thing. I recommend you don't do that. The points are fine where they are. You can press E when you have something selected, and now you can move it up. Now you can move it up, and now you can move it up. And suddenly, we can click on the other one. And now pretend we've got man with pants. go back to this. All right. Teeth. Teeth. Let's deal with that now before we go too far. As much as I want to deal with other stuff. Do we want to make it entirely separate? First, let's... It is very pink. It's the same color as this pink as Silbron's, so... Yes. Yes, it is. All I have to do is a new object. That's why I'm not sure. I mean, I can re-undo them. Redo the creases and stuff if I want to. The point over there, how does that even happen? One, two, three, four, five, six. We want these specifically attached to the top and then specifically attached to the bottom. I guess, yeah, it's six.
We'll have two different objects.
Tubular. Considering we can barely tell what's going on, I'm not going to worry about it too much. Okay. Let's see how that works then. Can't really select that, can we? It might have connected some of these, I just realized. Let's try to make sure that didn't happen. Extend your selection while control plus on numpad. It goes in both directions. Interesting. I was wondering what that was. I've never really dealt with anything in the numpad, and no one's ever said what that is. But I've seen people do that. All right. Vertex groups. Okay. Yeah, I have a basic idea of how it works. I've done shape keys enough to know that I actually have to press the button. So, how do you hide it specifically? Vertex group. Lower jaw. Hide. H. It's not really H. Took a little more than I was hoping for. Wait, we have a bit more selected than I should. Only had those. Remove. Minus that. Assign. H. That's a bit annoying. Let's get rid of... Why have that selected in the background? Header. How do I not hide it? Alt H? Yeah, but oh, okay. Okay. Oh wait, this is the same object now. Hey, maybe we could just make it part of it. It's better. It's not hidden anymore, though. I could probably make it its own thing, copy the whole thing, and then bring it over to make its own object after, if I wanted to. Like, let's add cube. One, two, three, four, five, six. Maybe shouldn't have put it all there. Let's try to... Much better. L to select linked objects that only select the jaw section we've been making. So if I press L with that. I guess I don't know what you mean. It's not doing anything. Unless you mean shift L. Control L, okay. This doesn't look right over here. What happened there? Gotta give these teeth some personality. It's a little weird to me, but it gets the basic idea. So now we've got to deal with whatever I did over here. Losing my mind slowly. In which way? What's happening? Box. What we need? We need that. The fish is on my shoulder. Back. Okay. Do you want to send me what's happening? Back having a bad time? Okay, I see it. I think you're making it too complicated. There's too many vertices there. For what you sent me. If you want to keep going with that, that's fine. Just it's gonna take a long time to do anything, if that makes sense. One thing that might help you in this situation, however, is up here, if you see what I'm doing up here. You can press on this, and this turns on soft selection. So everything in this circle here also gets selected to some degree, and you can scroll up and down with the scroll wheel to change how much it affects. Might be part of the jaw. There's no way that's part of the jaw. I think that just moved, and I accidentally selected that in the background. How do I unhide? No! Is it Alt H? Yes. I'm bad at this. Select H. Soft selection. Look at this perfect jawline we've got going here. It's weird, this curve. Also, did you see what I just said? Pink creature. Fluffy. With the soft selection. Yeah, I had the same problem with the first model I was messing with. Just too many vertices. Well, I see you in the server now to use it. Make it so you can actually say things now. Stuff selection is so nice, actually. Yes. Once you get used to it, it can be nice. It depends on the model. You don't always want to use it. I don't know how this happened, and I don't really know how to deal with it. Good enough, so I'll take it. Yeah. Just be over it at this point. Is this on the X? Yep. I press Z. So now, how do we want to present these teeth? Do we have it just like... It's control, not alt. Alt L did something else. I think we have it so the bottom jaw is going... It's going into the bottom jaw a bit, but it's just outside of the outside as well. That makes sense. So most of it's actually colliding with the rest of the model. Also just realized this isn't mirrored again. I can auto mirror. I wonder if that worked out optimally. I'm not sure. We'll hope that mirrored right. I like this auto mirror tool though that I've been using. Should be able to get a general shape for a tail, yeah. Retain shape and stuff, sure. Yeah. I want that to remain great, though. Just do that, and then this, and then bring it down a little bit. I've tried and died. It's a bit higher than it.
Oh.
Oh. I mean, it just looks so weird. It's got really tiny front teeth, though. Well, it's all gonna be inside, seemingly. Which I don't know how I feel about that right now.
I still kind of want to shear this. But maybe it's better like this and I just stop trying to make it so much like the picture. Pink teeth. Why is it shading so weird?
I want this bar to go around just so we can have the black gums be visible. But maybe we do hide the teeth entirely. Let's put all of this in a bit.
He's not even fat. Why would you do that to them?
Hmm.
I don't understand what's going on with the light here. Also, now I'm thinking about this. Hello, Rivotter. Doing okay. The lizard's coming out pretty okay too. Done two of the things you've dreaded. Well, that's good. I didn't think the collision actually affected the hand like that. Sorry. I mean, you could still do a very basic tail, depending on what you have. Because you could do something like... and then so on, and then just be good with it. This would be like six different pieces and then just be done with it. Maybe afterwards. So one thing you do want is a center line, and which is why I have auto mirror generally. And having a center line so you can mirror, that's not supposed to be good. Flat on the other side, even better then. Because you're baking a square, essentially. I'm shearing the tooth. Clipping merge. That's terrible. What is this face? It's gotten, yes. It disappears after a while. In some cases, it gets caught on the ears. I purposely changed some of the collisions so it can actually sit there a bit. Let's see if I can test the thing. I believe it's H. Not H. Is it L? Not the right one. I don't know which one it is. I can force anything to happen. I don't want it to come through there, actually. Last point, I want it to come through. Bring these down. Still texturing strangely. You sent me more things. Tail. That tail is very interesting. So the way I would do it is I would pretend all that exists is the... I could probably pull this picture into the model and make it. But I would pretend all the stuff in the bottom doesn't exist, and then just extrude one big thing out to where the first feather split is on the right. That's the big one. And then split where you want to, but have all the other splits, and then extrude downwards to make those all those splits of the tail that you have there. So you have two separate viewings of the tail, and I'm confused. It's hollow. Hmm. I kind of get what you mean, yeah. It's gonna look kind of weird here. You could, instead of making it an actual 3D, like, enclosed model, you could just make it a plane and just kind of extrude it that way and then extrude it out afterwards to make it that 3D shape, if you get what I mean. So if I add a plane... I made it pink too, cool. Add a plane, did it like this, did he. It's mirroring, so it looks weird. Then after all of that, I press E again, and then I have it thickness. That might be the better way for you to do that. Also, sorry, I'm not really showing what you're talking about. You get what I mean? You know how to extrude, right? It's edge-slotted. Extrude is here as well, but otherwise it's just pressing E. It still says it right there anyway. But you can extrude on just two points of a plane, and then you can bring it out. And you could subdivide, and then you can do smooth vertices and all that. I'm gonna get water a second. So I'll be right back. Whoa. Whoa. Amazing. Alright. Why?
Why would you say that?
I know the teeth line up with it. They just look weird, don't they? Try to make them a little bit spikier. It looks like all together. I want to make the lower teeth though. That doesn't look right.
It's unhappy.
If I do X, and now I exit out, now I add a cube. No objects to paste, huh? Yeah, but I wanna have it as its own object. P to separate by selection. Oh. Oh, I didn't know that was a thing. Okay. That makes it a lot easier. Making this a little too complicated, but fine. Yeah, that's annoying. Da 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 da. Ba da da. Ba 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 da ba. Up ba da ba 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 da 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 da. I know it looks bad, but it'll make sense in a second. Why does it look like this color? What's happening? What is this circle? Moose training on? Yeah. Maybe. Almost coming to number two. I feel like that's the most likely thing. Angie.
heck is that?
Why is this lion here? That may have fixed a lot of our problems. Is there a way to see normals? The circle button, the top right. It seems fine. It just looks so wrong. Like, that's not normal. What's going on there?
Stable smooth shading. I don't know where you do that.
I've forgotten shading. This is smooth shading. This is flat shading. So we were always on flat shading. Doesn't really look that good. It's disturbing to look at. Select the model. Going mesh and recon. Mesh in the top right. I'm more confused. Switch over to edit mode. Hotkey control N. Recalculate inside control shift N. That's a new file. Under the mesh mint. Recalculate outside. Under normal. Alt N. Cool. I do love seeing absolutely nothing happen. I'm seeing something. Like face center intersecting, yeah. Which message would say? Yeah, I mean that's definitely happening, but it's happening a lot. Like, all of these are doing it, which is why it's like, is something going on? Am I missing something? All of these are pretty unnatural, I guess. I just didn't expect all of them to be messed up. That's concave, seemingly for no reason. The idea where all the faces are, that's what I just did. Let's delete this face. Still pretty messed up. I don't remember why I did this. I had a very good reason. Sure it didn't recalculate enough. Feel like it did. Thank you. feel like that's not doing it. I feel like that didn't do anything. Well. What is that? Is that just this model? I think it is. I just can't tell what that actually looks like, yeah. Oh, man. It feels like it's basically there, but I can't tell. Like there's two surfaces there. Now it's completely different. And it's completely different again, how it looks. Like it's shiny. It is. All right, it's been 2.5 hours. I think I need to stop now. I'm liking where we've gotten with this so far. Ooh, but I have to stop because it's been long enough. Ooh. Alright, there's not really anyone I want to host right now. Need to help me out of the graph. Alright, well, thank you for stopping by. Yeah, if you also have anything to say, you can say it in that Discord. Good with anything. All right, yeah, I'm gonna stop for now. There's no one I want to host, so I'm gonna stop it. Might stream tomorrow, but definitely gonna stream Saturday. But probably not gonna be 3D modeling. But all right, goodbye.